turn to Italian Ambassador to India, His Excellency Ambassador Vincenzo Di Luca. Excellency, briefly, talking of Italy, what are the big takeaway for Italy from this summit? And also, Italy holds the presidency of the G20 and will co-host COP26 later this year. Several EU countries are also members of G20. In what way the India-EU summit outcomes will complement the agenda of G20 and COP26? Over to you, Excellency.
Thank you, Manish. Well, welcome to all my colleagues and Ambassador Romana from Brussels. I think there is a coincidence between the EU-India agenda and G20 and COP26 agenda. We will chair G20, we'll co-chair COP26 this year. G20 agenda has three pillars: people, planet, prosperity. Of course, when talk about people, we talk about also the present dramatic health challenges coming from the pandemics. And G20 will be focused on how to tackle this crisis all over the world. We will host next Friday an important summit, a global health summit, precisely discussing and trying to make proposals for a further international cooperation on health and pandemics. Second is planet. Planet is a major challenge is climate change and the process towards Glasgow. And also in this field, there is a sort of interaction between the discussion we have in G20 and the debate in EU-India summit. Third pillar is prosperity. Prosperity means an inclusive economic recovery all over the world. Now, coming to the challenge we discussed and also the outcomes of the EU-India summit, the leader summit, I think there are now potentials for really make progress in the main area of the partnership between India and Europe, that are trade, investment, and also the area of energy transition and digital transition. In these fields, I would like to mention some potential of this partnership. Europe is one of the most interconnected energy markets. We have an experience, a special experience in interconnection. And you know that interconnection in energy market is really one of the key to ensure energy efficiency and also to integrate renewable energy in electricity grid. So in this field, I think we can share experience in terms of technology, in terms of regulation, in terms of investment. I can tell you that Italy has 26 interconnection with European Union neighbor countries. And in India and in the region, when we talk about connectivity also, energy interconnection is vital to really integrate regions and integrate even the internal Indian market. Without interconnection, you cannot really tackle the challenge of energy efficiency and energy transition. The same is for digital transition. In Italy, we experienced the program of Industry 4.0, that is the interaction between digital service and manufacturing, the same here in India. So I think there is really a potential to go on in the framework established in Oporto. I would also say that this summit, compared with the previous exercises, because the special partnership between the European Union and India started in the year 2000, but now I think we have a political momentum, that's for sure, a political momentum to further really enhance this special and strategic partnership. I would also say that in this moment, in this very moment, we have a convergence between the member states partnership with India and the European Union partnership with India. We adopted, as Italy, with India, a plan of action for 5 years, precisely the same time frame of the partnership between European Union and India, in the same area of priorities, the same kind of direction in green economy, in energy transition, in food processing, in machinery, advanced technology. So I think this is really a momentum, both at political level, but also in the awareness of business community. Maybe we have to work more on this to support the political process, next negotiation, also with the involvement of the business community in Europe and in India, because at the end of the day, we can offer the condition for investment and trade, but our companies who decide to invest and to promote trade. So I think this process started in Oporto needs to be further support, but more awareness by the business community, civil society, as well as a dialogue between the parliaments, the European Parliament and the Indian Parliament, the Member State Parliament and the Indian Parliament. I think this is a process that should be inclusive of all the actors, and Oporto really has been a starting point, a very important new starting point in the strategic partnership between the European Union and India. And also in this summit in Oporto, we have seen how many synergies we can have between the summit and the G20 agenda, as I told you in my first remarks. So I think we have a lot of work to do here in India, in Europe. We have potential for even identify specific projects on energy transition, advanced manufacturing, on trade and investment, on technology, on research, on COVID and health policies and practices. We have done a lot in this last year. Italy in India in the last 12 months has promoted 12 new investment projects in the year of pandemics, in the year of COVID. That means there is a growing attention also of the private sector in investing more in India, from Europe to India, but also from India to Europe. And also people-to-people relation. We do not forget this point. This is very important, people-to-people connection, people-to-people relationship. We have increased the number of visa and the number of students from India to Italy, the same many other European Union countries. I think the process has to be really an inclusive process in this special relationship between the European Union and India. Thank you so much, Manish.